Namaskar, my dear students. Today in the dental materials section, we will be discussing the casting defects. This is a very important topic for theory exam. You can expect a long or a short note on any of one defect. It is often asked in the Viva also. Many MCQs are framed from this topic. So let's begin. You know, casting procedure is a technique sensitive procedure. Okay, proper sequence of all the steps is important. I have discussed the casting procedure in a separate video. I have shared the link also. So if the proper procedure is not followed, then what? Then the casting may have some defects. This can be in the form of that the casting may not fit properly. It may have poor mechanical properties or it may have poor aesthetics. So, what is a casting defect? A casting defect is any irregularity in the metal casting that is undesired. Now, these casting defects can be of various types. Let us classify them. These defects can be in the form of distortion, surface roughness, porosity, incomplete casting, or discoloration. Let us discuss them one by one. Let's start with distortion. Distortion actually means when we don't get a required size and shape of the casting. Okay, when there is a change of size and the shape, and this leads to the misfit of the casting. Okay, this can be caused due to two reasons. One, if there is a distortion of the wax pattern when we were fabricating the pattern. And second, due to the uneven movement of the walls of the pattern when the investment is setting. So, how it can be prevented? Always the prevention of a defect depends on the cause. If we remove the cause, the defect will be prevented. So first is proper manipulation of the wax. Let it be when we are fabricating the pattern, when we are doing the carving of the wax pattern. Okay. Second, the investing pattern should be done within 1 hour after finishing. Okay. It should be done as soon as possible. And if we have to prolong it, then what? If the storage is necessary, we have to store the wax pattern in the refrigerator so that minimal stresses are produced. The second casting defect that we are going to discuss is surface roughness. This roughness can be in the form of nodules, it can be in the form of ridges or veins, spines or fins. Now coming to the surface roughness. What is surface roughness? It is defined as relatively finely spaced surface imperfections. Okay, these are the imperfections on the surface whose height, width and direction it establishes the predominant surface pattern. You know, surface roughness is not desirable. Why? Because it will decrease the mechanical properties as well as the aesthetics of the casting. Okay, these surface roughness can be in the form of nodules, which are mainly caused due to the air bubbles entrapped. Okay, marked as A in the picture. Second, we have ridges or veins can be formed, which are formed due to the water films, marked as B in the picture. Spines or fins can be formed due to the foreign bodies which are entrapped during the casting, marked as C in the picture. Now first comes the nodules. These nodules can be formed of various sizes. First, large nodules can be caused due to the air entrapped during investing. Okay, when we are pouring the ring with the investment material. So this can be prevented by the use of vacuum investing technique, or we should tap the casting ring whenever we are doing the investment step. Second, multiple nodules can be formed. Again, this is formed due to the inadequate vacuum when the air is entrapped. So this can be prevented by first brush technique on the pattern. We know the wax pattern is made up of wax, which is hydrophobic. So the investment material with the brush can be applied on the pattern so that no air bubbles are entrapped. Second, surfactant application or a wetting agent application can also prevent these kind of bubbles. Third, some nodules are formed on the occlusal surface. These are caused due to the excessive vibration. So this can be prevented by avoiding excessive vibration during the investment. Second type of surface roughness which can be formed are the ridges in the veins. As we discussed that wax is hydrophobic, it is repellent to water. So if the investment, it becomes separated from the wax pattern, what will happen? A water film may form irregularly over the surface as we can see in the picture. Okay, so this appear as minute ridges or veins on the surface of the casting. Now, how we can prevent these ridges in the veins? First, by the optimum liquid powder ratio of the investment material. Because more the liquid, more chances of surface roughness. Second, application of wetting agent. As we know that water is repellent to water. So, by applying the wetting agent, it will decrease the chances of water films over the surface. Third is the brush technique. We should apply some investment material on the wax pattern with the brush so that there is increased contact of the wax pattern with the investment material and there are less chances of water films being trapped. Third types of surface roughness is fins and spines. You know, if there is a crack in the investment material, it leads to fins and spines in the casting. This can be caused due to too rapid heating. Okay, so this can be prevented by heating the ring gradually to 700 degrees Celsius in at least 1 hour. Second, if there is a higher water powder ratio of the investment material, this we discussed earlier also, more water, more chances of surface roughness. So we should use correct water powder ratio. Third, prolonged heating for a long time. That also causes the cracking and this leads to fins or the spines. So this can be prevented by complete the casting as soon as the ring is heated and it is ready. Okay. Fourth is due to the foreign body inclusion. Okay. This shows sharp, well-defined deficiencies. Okay, so this can be prevented by avoiding any kind of foreign body inclusion, maybe during the pattern fabrication or during the investing of the ring. Now, after surface roughness, the third casting defect that we will be discussing is porosity. It is a very important casting defect. It is asked as a separate question in the theory exam also. Porosity means having voids. Okay, now depending that if the porosity is on external surface or internal surface, it affects both the mechanical properties of the casting and the aesthetics. Okay, porosity can be classified depending on the cause as first due to the solidification defects. It can be localized shrinkage porosity, suckback porosity and microporosity. The second cause is due to the trapped gases. The porosity can be gas inclusion, pinhole porosity, and third is the subsurface porosity. The third cause of porosity can be due to the residual air which is trapped in the mold. It leads to the back pressure porosity. You know, this classification is very important. As I told you, it comes as a separate note. So let us start with the localized shrinkage porosity. Now first is the localized shrinkage porosity, also called as the shrink spot porosity. Okay, it is very important. It comes as a separate short note also in the theory exam. These are large irregular voids which are found in the sprue casting junction as we can see in the picture. Now what is the cause? Why are these porosities formed? You know, what is a sprue? Sprue is a channel which provides the molten metal to hole of the mold. Okay. So it should solidify the last so that it can supply the metal. What if the sprue, it freezes first or before the rest of the casting, then what will happen? It won't be able to supply the metal and this will lead to porosity. Okay, now the last portion of the casting to solidify, mainly the bulkiest portion of the casting, that is the sprue pattern junction, it gets the porosity in this case, which is called as the localized shrinkage porosity. Now the question is how we can prevent the localized shrinkage porosity. First is by using the sprue of correct thickness. The thickness of the sprue should be greater than the maximum thickness of the pattern. Okay, second, we should attach the sprue to the thickest portion of the wax pattern so that the mold, the metal, it remains in the molten state till whole the mold is filled. Okay, then flaring at the point of attachment. This will decrease any kind of turbulence, okay, any kind of hindrance of the flow of the metal to the mold. Last is placing a reservoir close to the wax pattern. You know, reservoir is a small amount of additional wax which can be added just below the wax pattern. It will keep the alloy in the liquid form till the whole of the mold cavity is filled. It will solidify last and it will prevent the localized shrinkage porosity. The second form of porosity due to the solidification defect is the suck back porosity. Suck back or the hot spot porosity, it usually occurs in the interior of the crown near the area of the sprue. It may occur at the occlusio-axial line angle or incisoaxial line angle if they are not well rounded. This type of porosity mainly occurs when there is impedance to the flow of metal. Now see this picture. The sprue is attached to the pattern at 90 degree. When the metal is flowing to the pattern, there is hindrance to the flow of metal. Okay, now see this. Sprue is attached to the pattern. The metal is entering the mold. But what is happening? It is creating a higher localized mold temperature because it is impinging onto the mold surface. And this region is called as hot spot. Okay, this hot spot, it retains a localized pool of molten metal. Okay, after the other areas of castings have solidified. So this creates a shrinkage void or a suck back porosity. Now, if we are attaching the sprue to the wax pattern at 45 degree, what will happen? There is no impedance, there is no hindrance to the flow. The metal will flow smoothly. Suckback porosity can be prevented by first flaring the point of sprue attachment. This will avoid any kind of impedance of the flow of metal. Second, proper placement of the sprue, that is the sprue angle, 45 degree to the wax pattern. Third, do not use excessively long sprue. Fourth, use a reservoir as we have discussed earlier also. And last but very important, reduce the mold temperature differential. Okay, we can lower the casting temperature by about 30 degrees Celsius and this will avoid creation of any kind of hot spot. The third type of porosity due to the solidification defect is the microporosity. Microporosity. Microporosity are in the form of small irregular voids. You know, they are not detectable unless the casting is sectioned. Okay, they are mainly present in the fine grain alloy casting due to the rapid solidification. Why rapid solidification? Because of the low casting temperature or the mold temperature. So how it will be prevented? It will be prevented by the increase in the melting temperature or increase in the mold temperature. After the solidification defects, there are certain porosity which are due to the trapped gases. First, we will discuss gas inclusions and pinhole porosity. Gas inclusions or the pinhole porosities, they are mainly caused by the entrapment of the gases, both of them during the solidification. What is the difference? Difference is in the size. The gas inclusion porosities are usually much larger as compared to the pinhole porosities, as we can see in the picture also. Now, many metals, they dissolve the gases while they are molten. Okay, this is the reason how they are formed. For example, both copper and silver, they dissolve the oxygen in large amounts in the liquid state. And molten platinum and the palladium, they have strong affinity for hydrogen as well as oxygen. Okay, so on solidification, what happens? The absorbed gases, they are expelled and the porosity results. Now, in the entrapped gases, there is one another type of porosity, which is the subsurface porosity. Subsurface porosity. It is mainly caused by the simultaneous nucleation of the solid grains and the gas bubbles when the alloy freezes at the mold walls. We can see this type of porosity as shown in the picture. Now, how we can prevent this? We can prevent this or diminish this by controlling the rate at which the molten metal it enters the mold. Now, the third reason for causing porosity is the residual air which is trapped in the mold. This is called as the back pressure porosity. Back pressure porosity. It mainly occurs on the inner surface of the casting. It produces as large concave depressions as we can see in the picture also. Now, how this type of porosity is formed? Let us understand. When we invest the pattern, the thickness of the investment material from the pattern to the end of the casting should be around 6 mm depending on the density of the investment material. Okay, but what happens if the thickness of the investment material is more? There will be inability of the air in the mold to escape through the pores in the investment. Okay, the investment should be porous so that it allows the air to escape, and second, it should be of optimum thickness. If it is thicker, it will not allow that entrapped air to pass through. So it will create a pressure gradient. It will displace that air pocket towards the end of the investment via the molten sprue and the button. Okay, air has to escape. Now, this entrapment will be found as a pocket, as a concavity on the cavity surface of the crown or the mesio-occlusal distal casting. Now, how to prevent the back pressure porosity? First, a proper burnout is required so that there is no air entrapped in the mold cavity. An adequate mold and casting temperature, again, which will help in the proper burnout. A sufficiently high casting pressure, then proper liquid powder ratio which help to eliminate any kind of entrapped air porosity. Thickness of the investment, as we discussed, it is very important. The thickness should be around 6 mm between the tip of the pattern and the end of the ring. It should not be greater than that. Okay. After discussing the porosities, let us discuss the next casting defect, which is the incomplete casting. Incomplete casting. You know, incomplete casting is a type of casting defect when the molten metal is unable to fill the extremities of the mold, the ends of the mold cavity. Okay, it results in unfilled cavities, as we can see in the picture, rounded margins. How it is caused? The causes of the incomplete casting are, the first is the inadequate sprueing if the sprue former is too small. Second, alloy is not hot enough. So what will happen? It will not go into the mold cavity completely. Thin wax pattern, then incomplete elimination of the wax residues. In this case, you can see the casting with rounded margins and shiny appearance. Okay, then mold is too cold. Then also, the metal will not flow into the ends of the mold cavity. Ingate is obstructed. If the path is obstructed, how will the metal flow into the mold cavity? Then insufficient casting force. This also leads to the incomplete casting. Now, how we can prevent these incomplete casting? First, eliminate all the causes. Okay, so prevention is easier. First, use proper size of sprue former. Then the casting temperature should be higher than the liquidus temperature of the alloy, so that alloy's mold is in molten state when it is going into the cavity. Then ensure that no debris, it blocks the ingate. Use adequate amount of force for the casting so that metal goes into the extremities of the mold cavity. Now, the last casting defect that we will be discussing is discoloration. It is very, very important. Discoloration. You know, what are the causes of discoloration of casting? First is the sulfur contamination of the casting, okay, which causes the black casting. What happens when there is overheating of the investment material above 700 degrees Celsius for the gypsum bonded investment? It decomposes, liberating sulfur or sulfur compounds. And this combines with the metals in the gold alloy and forms a sulfide film. It causes the dark casting, and this cannot be cleaned by pickling also. Okay, another reason is incomplete elimination of the wax pattern. It also causes black casting. How? You know, when the wax is not properly eliminated, a carbonized wax, it sticks to the surface of the casting. And though it can be removed by heating over a flame. Third reason is contamination with copper during pickling or contamination with mercury, which also causes discoloration. Now, how this discoloration can be prevented? First, by avoiding the overheating of the investment. As we discussed, the sulfur contamination will not be there. Then avoid the use of torch flame as it contains sulfur. Then avoid use of steel tongs to hold the casting during pickling. It will avoid the contamination. Fourth is that the castings should never be placed with amalgam dyes or kept on a table where the amalgam scrap is present. It will again prevent any kind of contamination. Now with this, we have discussed all the casting defects. I again repeat, it is a very important topic. You may get a long note on casting defects. Then you may get a separate note on porosities, maybe combined with the steps of the casting procedure. You may get a separate short note on localized shrinkage porosity, hot spot porosity, and the back pressure porosity. Okay, if we talk about multiple choice question, the questions are basically based on the prevention or the causes. So if you know the causes, you know the prevention also. I'm sure this video will really help you to prepare the topic well. Do not forget to like and share the video, my dear students. You can give your topics in the comment section. I will try to cover them soon. And please subscribe for more and more learning. Wish you success today and always.